bad idea. But the boy's dying over there in Vietnam.
There's something I gotta do.
I ever tell you how I got this?
Sure, you stole it.
That idea here. I let the pocket of this old white man used to come around here raising him. Take this with you. It's always brought me good luck.
I can't do that.
I know you think you're alone in this world, Lincoln. But you're not. You never will be.
How you doing, guys, and welcome to another video where I'll be taking a look at the PlayStation Plus titles available in August 2018. The first title I'll be looking at is Mafia 3. Now, Mafia 3 was released for the PlayStation 4 in October 2016, which is a sequel to Mafia 2, which was released back in 2010, and that in itself was a sequel to the original Mafia, which released all the way back in 2002. Now, straight off the bat, some people may be put off by this idea. Because Mafia 3 is the third game in the series, some people may be thinking that it'll be pointless in buying and playing this game because they haven't played Mafia 1 and 2. Well, I can tell you that that doesn't matter, because even though Mafia 3 is a sequel to those two games, the story and characters are all completely new. So basically, you don't have to have played the first two Mafia games to follow this game. Although that being said, there are a bunch of throwbacks to the original games in this one. For example, Vito Scaletta, the guy right here, he was the main protagonist in Mafia 2. You actually got to play as this guy. Whereas in this game, you don't get to play as him, but it's nice to see a returning familiar face and all. Now, the story of Mafia 3 has you playing as a black character called Lincoln Clay. Now, the fact that he is black actually plays very important into the story, but I'll get more into that later. Basically, the game is set in 1968, just a few short years after the real-life Vietnam War, and Lincoln Clay is a returning Vietnam vet. He returns home after that war and finds it difficult to adjust back into the life, and it's really interesting for this. He's a returning soldier, and all of a sudden he's expected to return back to a normal life. You can see that he struggles with it at certain different parts, and some of these moments can be pretty emotional and really make you think about what it will be like to be a returning soldier with possible post-traumatic stress disorder. Now, the game is set in a fictional city called New Bordeaux, which in itself is based on the real-life city of New Orleans, which is in the deep south of America. And this is where the fact that Lincoln is black comes into play. You see, the deep south of America back then was incredibly racist, and the fact that your main character you're playing as is a black man plays hugely into the story. Every now and then you'll hear some people comment, calling him names just literally for no reason, just the fact that he's walking down the street, and it's really powerful stuff. At the beginning of this game, when you first board it up, there's actually a disclaimer that says, and it actually warned you about any racism or possible colorful language. But it also says that they decided specifically to keep these things in the game because they felt that by removing the racism would be a massive disservice to the real life racism that took place in the 60s in the deep south of America. So they decided to keep it in to properly, accurately portray the real life shame that pretty much every city at that time faced. Without going into too much spoiler territory, the basic story of this game is Lincoln Clay is hired by the mob to do a job. He completes the job, but then gets completely betrayed by the mob. They proceed to kill all his family and friends, and even shoot Lincoln himself in the head, leaving him for dead. Unfortunately for them though, Lincoln doesn't die, and he comes back with a vengeance so he can get some revenge. Graphically speaking, this is a pretty impressive looking game. Character models look great, and I think they especially deserve praise for the voice acting, which is absolutely top notch in this game. And seeing as how this game plays very, very strongly on story and characters, having a strong voice cast really, really makes that so much better, and they definitely deserve praise for that. Even the city of New Bordeaux itself looks great. This being an open world game means that you can freely explore around the area, and it looks great. They even added radio stations that play songs from the 60s to give it that much more authentic feel. But then we actually get onto the gameplay side of things, and this is a real mixed bag. Don't get me wrong, it's not that the gameplay itself is bad. In fact, a lot of the gameplay mechanics are really fun. As I've said, this is an open world game where you can freely drive around, and the driving mechanics are actually pretty fun and very smooth to handle. When you actually are on missions, you have a choice of how you can accomplish them. You can go in all guns blazing, or you can take a much more stealthy and sneaky approach. I personally, being a stealth fan, find it much more rewarding to go in quietly and try and take out as many guards as I possibly can without being seen. But that's just my personal preference of playstyle. It's completely up to you whichever one you want to do. If you want to go in all shooting bullets left, right and center, then you can do. So, it's not that the gameplay itself is bad, it's more that it's very, very repetitive. And I mean tediously repetitive. You see, basically what you have to do on the game to get your revenge on the mob is you have to take over the entire city, district by district. And how you do this is you make your way into a district and slowly take over the individual parts of that. This can be done through various different ways, like for example, taking out the local leader of that area or various other things. All well and good so far, until you realize that you will be doing this exact same thing dozens of times over for every single area of every single district of the entire world map, and it gets very, very repetitive. Don't get me wrong, they have tried to spice things up by scattering collectibles all around the map for any of you completionists out there. The only problem is, getting all these collectibles really doesn't get you anything at all. Take for example, one of the collectibles in this game is actually a returning thing from Mafia 2, and that is the Playboy magazines. Scattered all around the city are a bunch of different Playboy magazines that you collect and look at, if you know you want to. But the only problem with this mechanic is there's literally no point to it whatsoever. I mean, at least in Mafia 2, if you collected all the Playboy magazines, at the very least you got a trophy. But in this game, you literally get nothing. You can collect every single Playboy magazine in the entire city and you won't get anything, not even a trophy. There's also various other different types of collectibles where the same thing, you don't actually get anything. So it begs the question, what is the point in having such a mechanic in the game? Then of course there's the problems with the pacing of this game. Now as I've already said, this game is very heavily reliant on story and characters, but that can be both a good thing and a bad thing. For example, it takes absolutely ages for this game to get fully started. When you first start the game, it acts as sort of like a tutorial that very slowly drags you through a very boring opening sequence. You have to be playing the game for at least a good few hours before you can even get into the point where it is open world and you can go off and do your own thing at your own pace. I mean, that just seems ridiculous to me. If you take another open world game series like Grand Theft Auto for example, pretty much everything is open to you straight off the bat. You can go off and explore till your heart's content. But in this game, you literally have to slog through an hour long prologue before you can do anything else, and it's really annoying. Don't get me wrong, this prologue does a great job of setting up the characters and the story, but if you don't care about that kind of stuff and you just want gameplay, then this can turn a lot of people off before they've even got into the game. Now, since the release of this game, the developers have really concentrated on updating this game to make it better and add in different elements. For example, some of the new things that were brought in were the inclusion of street races, and the ability to change your character's clothes, and the ability to enter slow motion while driving and shooting. For example, when you're driving at top speed, with a simple press of a button, you can enter slow motion for a few split seconds, which will make controlling your car much easier. Then afterwards, the bar fills up more or less straight away, so you can use this mechanic to your heart's content. Now, I bought this game on day one of release, and none of these mechanics were in the game when it first released, so it's really nice that the developers chose to carry on supporting this game and carry on putting completely free updates that anyone and everyone can enjoy without having to shell out for DLC. Overall, this is a very fun game that unfortunately has some problems. If you can look past all the problems that I've mentioned, then chances are you can have yourself a lot of fun with this game. And if you're subscribed to PlayStation Plus, you can download this game right now absolutely free. So, there you have it guys, that was my look at Mafia 3. Join me again soon where I'll be taking a look at the next game available through the PlayStation Plus program for August 2018. Thank you for watching my video, and I'll see you next time.
Taught us kids to turn the other cheek, not fight back. Problem is that don't work. Not in the real world.